Hello, I'm Dick.
And I'm Eric, and we're the Annuity Guys.
Eric, we still get calls fairly regular about folks wondering, well, just how safe are annuities?
Well, we're annuity guys. They have to be safe, don't they?
Of course we're going to say they're safe. but really, there's a lot of detail.
And there's some big misconceptions out there.
Yes.
And usually the biggest one that's out there, because you've got some guaranteed rates on fixed annuities and those types of things that are out there, people think, well, aren't these like FDIC insured? And that's the biggest misconception. Annuities, insurance companies do not fall underneath FDIC insurance.
Well, and we regularly have to put disclaimers out there, not FDIC insured, only guaranteed by the claims paying ability of the company.
Right.
And yet there is another aspect that we get asked about quite a bit, and that's the guarantee associations, which is not FDIC.
Right.
And we're not even supposed to talk about it.
No. And as an insurance agent, you're not supposed to use that as an incentive to sell a policy, that there's any kind of
right.
The first and foremost aspect is the claims paying ability of the carrier. And that's really what is
what you want to focus on. Yeah. Right, right.
Yeah. So, but if you want to know about the guarantee associations, there are websites, and I know in the past you even called them.
I did. I called the state of Illinois, the insurance commissioner's office, and asked them, well, what should I say when somebody asks me?
We're not supposed to talk about this, so what do we do?
Yeah. So, because people have a right to information. Right. This is America. We do get to speak freely. So they said, well, just have them call us. And I mean, I have understood that, you know, when someone asks a question about a policy they've already purchased and they want to know, because that's right in the policy.
Right.
It talks about, you know, there's information about that.
Yeah.
You know, you can talk about it then, but you're just not supposed to talk about it in terms of
the short answer is, if you have a question about the guarantee association, call your state department of insurance,
because
each state is regulated
is
by their own department of insurance.
Well, and since we work in different states, or you do, I should say, in terms of helping people with, you know, their planning and, you know, products, this type of thing, that the states vary anywhere from, I've seen, from $100,000 in a guarantee association clear up to $500,000, and Illinois is about $250,000, and so
that makes it really confusing
with FDIC. I think we've covered that.
So getting around the misconceptions, what are some of the considerations someone needs to utilize when they're thinking about, how safe is an annuity or an insurance product?
I think the most important thing is the third-party ratings.
Yeah.
Now, a lot of different rating services out there.
You mean there's not just one? You can say, all right, here's the rating.
5 to 7.
Yeah, the universal rating is this. Yeah, and that's the problem.
Yes.
You've got AM Best, Fitch's, S&P.
Comdex.
So you've got multiple places to go.
Right.
And they're not all universally the same.
No. And so, you know, you really have to kind of study how they rate, how many ratings they have, you know, what they use as a criteria for their ratings. And we tend to fall back pretty strong on the AM Best because they've always specialized in insurance, have been around for in excess of 100 years.
Yeah. They're just the historical contextual aspect of them having the experience to really evaluate these companies.
Exactly.
Now, I would usually, when I spend time with clients, the one thing I always talk about when you're evaluating companies, you're using that AM Best rating in this example to compare one company to the other. But make sure you're always using the same rating from the same agency. So if you use AM Best for the first company, use AM Best for the second company.
And we've seen that sleight of hand used. You know, it's like, well, this is an A-plus company.
Yeah.
You know, but you switch rating services.
Yeah. It's like, Mrs. McGillicuddy's third grade class. This was an A-plus. So it's understanding and being able to compare. And then being able to then decipher what those ratings truly mean.
Exactly, because with 16 ratings, I mean, they go in gradations, you know, from...
And that 16 is an AM Best. You could have 12 here and 9 over here.
It might go from a B minus to a B to a B plus to an, you know, A to an A minus to an A plus.
Yeah.
And so what I do love about the rating services is that, you know, folks, Eric and I, from our own experience, have seen is that very rarely does anything change fast for an insurance company.
Yeah.
So that is a somewhat of a safety net to understand it. Typically, you have a certain a reasonable length of time to see that an insurance right. company is going the wrong direction.
Right, and that's looking at they have, not only you have your A+, then you have a sub kind of issue of a positive outlook or a negative outlook.
Or stable
outlook. So it's inches within this kind of gradations of movements and understanding kind of where they're going.
Yes.
And the nice thing is they're stated fairly concisely in the summary reports.
Yes.
So you can find that information. Now, I do always have one disclosure that I like to get out there. Mm-hmm. And you have to realize the insurance companies are paying for these ratings.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
They're the ones that are deciding that they're going to go out and spend the money to have some third party come in and evaluate them.
Right.
I'm not saying the fox is watching the hen house, so to speak, but I want you to understand that most of these companies, when they decide to go out and pay for them, it's mm-hmm. because they're pretty financially sound.
Exactly.
They're in the upper echelon of companies that are, so mm-hmm. if they have a rating, it's because they want you to know, hey, we're doing something well.
Right.
You wouldn't pay for bad advertising.
Exactly.
So you don't see very many D's and F's.
Bad companies.
But just understand, it's abilities to measure one company against another one.
Well, and Eric, too, we mentioned, stable, negative, positive ratings, and typically it'll take sometimes years for it to just change from a positive to a stable, or a stable to a negative. And so to actually drop from say an A+ down to an A, it could happen in a relatively short period of time, but not very likely that it would drop from an A+ down to a B or a C.
Yeah.
Without giving you plenty of advance warning.
Yeah, it's not like you're failing a test and your grade goes on after the final exam from an A down to a C overnight.
Right.
Doesn't happen
right.
in this industry too often.
Well, and I think that, to explain why that happens, folks, there's a type of accounting that insurance companies are held to, and it's really a statutory type of accounting as compared to the GAAP accounting, generally accepted
accounting principles,
for public corporations. And really, statutory accounting is like a show-me-the-cash type of accounting. You can't hide the expenses. And
you can't bury the good stuff, make our price
the bad
go
stuff,
up.
Yeah. So in essence, when these third-party rating agencies are looking at these companies, it is very transparent and everything is kind of out front. So that's why there's not the same surprises in this industry as there would be in like the public held corporations, where sometimes they do play some games and get away with it.
Well, insurance companies are oftentimes quite proud of their reserves.
Right.
That's what they're using to publicize and say, look how much we have in backing. Every dollar in liabilities we have out there, we have $1.08 on reserve.
Exactly.
So, they use those types of numbers to say, hey, look and see, we're sound, we're solid, so we can ride the ups and the downs. We know we have those things controlled. And that's how they use to show those pieces, that reserve requirement.
Exactly.
And obviously, the state is going in, and each of these companies is regulated usually within a state, and they have to prove where they're at.
Yes.
And so to be able to state those things, they have to have gone through these financial investigations. And then when the regulators come in, if these insurance companies are not up to snuff, then they take immediate action.
Right, they do. And it's really different, again, than the public held corporations, because an insurance company will not, hardly ever will you see an insurance company that actually fails in the sense of bankruptcy.
Right.
They go into receivership. Because the assets are typically there.
The money's there.
To protect the client. It's just that it's moved over now to a profitable company because they weren't managing their insurance company properly.
Yeah, usually the state will come in and say, hey, we're going to put you in a conservatorship aspect. We're going to oversee these pieces. And then if you can't get your act in order, we're going to actually probably usually sell you off to somebody that's doing it.
Right.
And the industry self-polices very well.
Exactly.
That's one of the things.
Yes.
The insurance companies realize that you're not going to purchase insurance if you cannot count on those guarantees.
Right.
So even within the industry, now you have to realize there's not big failures typically because you have such a high degree of reserves. So by having that high degree of reserves, it allows another company to come in and make a smaller investment to be able to take it and take those over.
Eric, everybody remembers back when AIG got in all that trouble.
But it wasn't. Well, it was their investment division.
You're right. It was the investment division, and actually there was a retraction on CNN because CNN put out that so many people have life insurance and annuities and this type of thing with AIG, and kind of gave the impression that that money could be at risk.
Right.
And they had to actually come out and do a retraction and say, you know, based on what the insurance commissioner has told us, blah, blah, blah. And through this whole financial crisis, AIG's insurance continued to maintain an A rating.
Yeah.
And basically, the assets were all there, and there was never an issue with that portion of AIG.
Yeah. So the insurance and annuity side, fine. The
right.
investment side, not so good. But yeah. This historically has been one of the safest places that you could actually have money.